Okay, welcome back again, everybody. I'm Charlie, SwordofSurvival.com. On this episode, I'm going to show you another technique of making another survivor bow. This is when you got a little bit more time, and you have time to whittle and carve and shape your bow to make it last a little bit longer. Okay, this piece here is made from the desert willow. It's also green, so it probably won't last as long as a seasoned piece of wood will, but it will last a whole lot longer than the green sapling bow that we talked about on a different post. So basically what I do is, when I get one, I like to start with one about five and a half feet long. You want to find where the natural bend of it is, and then once you do that, you want to find where the center is. Then from the center, you want to go 3 inches to the left and 3 inches to the right for your handle. And then once you start there, then this is going to be the top part of your bow. This would be considered the bottom part of your bow. Of course, you got your left and right ends. So what you're going to start doing is, from the end of your handle, you'll start whittling away this wood to where it goes from thick to thin all the way to the back here, leaving at least a half inch, 3/4 inch on each end. So it'll kind of taper off as you're starting to remove the wood from the bottom on each end. Okay, that one end is a little bit smaller, so you may not have to take as much wood from there. So what you want to try to do is balance out each side that you're whittling off of. If this side's thicker, you want to try to match it with the thin side. Okay, so when you're carving it out, trying to keep ends, both ends matched up as far as thickness and width. So what I'm going to start doing is, I'll start working on this because it's going to take a while to do it, and it'll use up a lot of recording space. So I'll break it, stop the tape, and then I'll work on it and come back in segments, and then till we finally get to the end of it. So I'll be right back soon. Okay, it's Charlie. I'm back. Completed my bow to the point where I can now use it if I need it. Like I demonstrated or explained to you before I started, you notice on the bottom I took out pretty much half of the shaft, working my way down and tapering off at the end on both ends, leaving my handle, the thick part in the middle. Now once I get down to the ends, you'll want to cut grooves into it like this to put your strings in, just like so. Here's one, here's the end with the string on it already. Okay, once you tie it off one end, you just basically, I don't know if you can see this, but you're going to take, I have my staff in my left hand, my string in right hand is tied off at the bottom. I'm going to bring my left leg through, and the bottom of the tied off ends are going to be braced with my right ankle. Then you just slowly bend. You got to know where the breaking point of this bow is at, so you don't, you know, over bend it and break it. So once you get it, you can tie it off on the end. Secure it so it doesn't slip on you. Then you have your bow. Now here it's kind of bent a little bit more here, so I'm going to have to go up. Like, notice this nice bend here, and it's bending a little bit more here. What you're going to have to do is, you're going to have to tiller it. Tillering this means that it's kind of thin here, so it's kind of, I see that now it's a little thicker here, so I have to go in there and take off a little bit more here, so it'll bring this bend back and forth. But there, right now this bow has about a 35 pound pull to it, maybe 30, but as these limbs season up and they get dry, it'll put more force in the sling of the arrow. So when you make the arrows, you want the arrows about half as long as your bow. So what I'm going to have to do is this, I'm going to go back and I'm done with it for video purpose, but for my own peace of mind, I'm going to go back and remove some right here so that I can get this sharp bend out, get my tillering correct. So there you have it. I'll cover some more bows from different woods to give you an idea different type of woods you can use and different type of bow setups that you can make. So this is Charlie, swordsurvival.com. Stay prepared, stay alive. See you back soon.